ArcGIS Online underpins a lot of the work that we do, even if we're not using the application in its own right. It's a repository for the user name, the named users, for the data sets, and some of the capabilities. ArcGIS Online is a SaaS. It's a software as a service offering, which means that you don't have to maintain it yourselves. It's something you connect to ongoing. It's growing rapidly, both in terms of capability and also in terms of use. We see that across New Zealand, and we also see it, globally. The nice thing about ArcGIS Online is the new capabilities come included in the application without you having to do an upgrade. The slight downside is you don't control when those upgrades happen, so being aware of what's coming in the new version is really important, and there's actually an early adopter version of ArcGIS Online that you can get access to preview what's coming before the production version comes into to being. One thing I want to note down here in terms of what's coming is the security aspect of FedRAMP moderate. FedRAMP is a US-based rating for security on cloud-based applications, and ArcGIS Online has recently received the FedRAMP moderate status. That's yet to be updated publicly on the US sites, but please be aware that that's something that's going to be officially acknowledged soon and can give you more confidence in the way that you use ArcGIS Online along with your on-prem applications. We'll see ArcGIS Online pop up in a number of demonstrations as we go through the morning. One thing I do want to focus on, which has improved a lot in ArcGIS Online, is its ability to do data management. So data management maybe is not the most exciting aspect of GIS. We haven't got 3D fly-through clouds like we had in Fran's demo, but it's a fundamental component of ArcGIS and any GIS that means we can be confident the data sets we're using are safe, secure, accurate, and up-to-date. In terms of those data management capabilities, previously that was something you might do with desktop tools like ArcGIS Pro. More and more, that's available through ArcGIS Online. One of those capabilities is the integration to other core applications. The one in the bottom left here, which is marked as new, is the new data import application. So that's data pipelines. Data pipelines is a new capability. It's been in beta for a while. It's now been released fully in production. And it allows you to connect to other non-GIS data sources, as well as some GIS data sources, and bring those in as a layer to use instead of ArcGIS Online. Integration is one of those things that causes many IT headaches. This can help in a number of scenarios. Essentially, it's about ingesting information, doing some data engineering on the way through to do some transformation, and then using that as a GIS layer within your ArcGIS. To give us an example of data pipelines in use, I want to pass across to not Ed Cook, but Justin, disguised as Ed Cook. Right. Justin.
Thank you, Scott. Extracting, transforming, and loading data are integral tasks for GIS professionals. With the February ArcGIS Online update, you can now perform these tasks using data pipelines. ArcGIS data pipelines enable you to connect to and read vector or tabular data from a variety of data stores using credits in the process. You are then able to transform this data and write it to a feature layer in ArcGIS Online. You can also automate and schedule these workflows, allowing them to be run on regular intervals. You'll notice that data pipelines are is a no-code graphic user interface. On the side panel, you can see that it is made up of three elements: inputs, tools, and outputs. The input data can be from files in ArcGIS, cloud storage such as Amazon S3 buckets, databases, or ArcGIS Online feature layers. To use files from ArcGIS Online, click on the file option and browse to the file you would like to choose. To bring in a data set from a public URL, simply copy-paste the URL in and select the correct data format. To bring in a data set from a cloud store, such as Amazon S3, you'll need an access key, secret key, or bucket name. Once you have access to the data store, all you need is the file name to bring into your data set. Once your data has been loaded into data pipelines, you can preview it to ensure that it was successful. Your data can now be processed using one of the five tools from the categories shown here. The clean tools can be used to remove unnecessary fields, modify fields, or fill missing values. Construct tools can be used to create geometries and calculate fields. Format tools can be used to change field formats and projections. Integrate tools can be used to join and relate to other tables. Finally, output will create or update feature layers in ArcGIS Online. Here, the Create Geometry tool has been used to create a points feature class, and again, we can preview to ensure that the data has been correctly processed. A useful capability of ArcGIS data pipelines is the Schedule Task feature. Here, you can create a task to update a feature layer when the data source has been edited, whether that's once an hour, once a month, or once a week. To do this, select the start date and how often it is to be repeated. This will now run without your computer even needing to be on. You can also decide how the feature layer will be written. Will it be created anew, replaced, or added and updated to? This example is just one way you can use ArcGIS data pipelines. In this project, you can see a workflow created to enrich a feature layer that was created earlier. In this case, the Christchurch Schools layer is enriched with population data. This is done using statistical areas to join them. Running this pipeline creates a new enriched feature layer in no time. If I've piqued your interest, we've also created some extra resources to help you get started with ArcGIS data pipelines. This story map contains the examples shown in this demo, alongside some more ideas to help you get started. We're excited to hear how you'll use it. Back to you, Scott.